This is one of the most important topics we could be discussing right now, as our oceans face an unprecedented set of challenges. So talking about conserving what we have left is insufficient. It's time to rebuild our oceans. And aquaculture, done right, can be part of this solution. Aquaculture is a resource-efficient means of animal protein production. And with the right growing practices, species, gear, and methods, aquaculture can be a force to improve rather than degrade water quality.
The Nature Conservancy is focused on producing food on land and in the water in ways that use the power of nature and create positive benefits for ecosystems and people. Restorative aquaculture is regenerative agriculture's analog in aquatic environments, and it may be one of the best opportunities to restore marine ecosystems and generate a financial return. We have an opportunity before us to ensure aquaculture grows to be a force for good. But we have to act now to shape the industry for the better and ensure a broader uptake of restorative practices on the ground.
We're proud that this final report was a very collaborative process with co-authors from 12 different organizations, including TNC.
I feel like this is a concept that really does come from farmers. I mean, my view is that it's not an academic concept by any means. Rather, it's emerged from industry.
People that have been involved with shellfish farming have seen anecdotally for years that their farming practices can have strong environmental benefits.
A lot of these observations now have captured the imagination of the scientific community. And now we've got a whole generation of students who are going to be jumping on that. And we're using the full weight and science of the aquaculture toolbox for environmental improvement. You know, that's really exciting.
It is crucial that we find solutions to reduce CO2 loads in the oceans. And the seaweed farming is the one scalable opportunity we have available to us today.
China is actually promoting ecological aquaculture and sustainable green development of aquaculture in the hope of maximizing the ecological and economic benefits.
There is actually evidence emerging that aquaculture can provide habitat in a way that supports the recruitment of some species.
An important pathway for aquaculture contributing to climate change is that it provides low carbon footprint products.
I think shellfish and seaweed farming as aquatic products with low carbon footprint, but also have the ability to absorb carbon, have great potential to help China achieve its goals of carbon peak and carbon neutrality.
At Hog Island, we require a healthy ecosystem to grow the bivalves that we grow. We need healthy eelgrass. We need healthy fisheries around our farms.
As somebody who spent some years working with aquaculture planners in Australia, I think that restorative aquaculture can become a very useful part of the toolkit for coastal zone and aquaculture planners moving forward.
I deal with students, young people all the time, and they're demanding that we rethink food production systems.
Figuring out ways to translate these incredibly useful but large-scale ideas into farm practices is going to be super critical, and we now have some better tools for doing that.
Overall, new policies, coastal value chains, and adaptive planning for building resilient coastal communities is not only desirable but essential if we are to increase the decency of living and advance local and global environmental benefits.
I think, well, if you take into consideration of our children, our grandchildren, taking care of nature is always it's a good investment.
Restorative aquaculture is critical to help us avoid further harm and even benefit aquatic ecosystems through food production. At Oceans 2050, we're excited by the release of the Global Principles of Restorative Aquaculture and commend the work of the Nature Conservancy and the authors from the many partner organizations on this new and innovative report.